ఎలక్ట్రిక్ పొటెన్షియల్ ఎలక్ట్రిక్ పొటెన్షియల్ physically it will explain the availability of the charge, the magnitude of the charge at a particular point. The more availability of the charge, more potential. Less availability of the charge, less potential. In an analogy, water flow by virtue of level difference, gas diffusion by virtue of pressure difference, and again current flow is by virtue of potential difference. As the water flows from higher level to lower level, as the gas flows from higher potential, higher pressure to lower pressure, similarly current flows from higher potential to the lower potential. Current flow is due to the by virtue of potential difference. As long as there is a level difference, water flows. As long as there is a pressure difference, gas flows. As long as there is a potential difference, the current flows. Current flow is determined by the potential difference. Now, what is the electric potential? The availability of the charge. For in a comparison, in a container there is a water. In a container there is a water. Your container is similar to the conductor. Water is similar to the charge. Level of the water is similar to the electric potential. More amount of water, more level. More amount of charge, more potential. Less amount of water, less level. Less amount of charge, less potential. Therefore, the physical status of the charge can be explained through a particular quantity that is called electric potential. Right? Whenever the charge is there, there is an electric field. Electric field is there, there is a electrostatic potential energy is defined at every point. From point to point, there is a potential energy difference. That potential energy difference per unit charge is called electric potential. Now, in another words, ground is the reference point. Right? If the position of the particle changes, gravitational potential energy also changes. Similarly, there is a charge, there is an electric field. At a particular point, electrostatic potential energy is defined. There is a mass, around the mass, there is a gravitational field. At every point in the gravitational field, there is a gravitational potential energy. Similarly, there is a charge, around the charge, there is an electric field. In the electric field, at any point, we can define electrostatic potential energy. At different points, the electrostatic energy, electrostatic potential energy is different. From point to point, the electrostatic potential energy is changed. As the electrostatic potential energy is changed, the change of potential energy per unit charge, the change of potential energy per unit charge is called electric potential. Now, in this case, electrostatic field is a conservative field. Electrostatic field is a conservative field. Work done against to the conservative field is stored in the form of potential energy. Here is also electric field is a conservative field. Now, Therefore, your work done against to the electric field is stored in the form of potential energy. That potential energy is called electrostatic potential energy. From point to point, the potential energy changes. Electrostatic potential energy changes. Per unit charge, what is the change of potential energy between any two points? That potential energy change between any two points per unit charge is called electric potential. In another words, how to define the electric potential? Now let us consider, there is a point, there is a charge Q. Around the charge Q, there is electric field. That point is, that charge is located at a point O. Now at this point P, right, what is the potential? Right. Now, take a reference point which is at infinity. While defining the gravitational potential energy, Earth surface is the reference surface. Earth surface is taken as the reference point. While defining the electric potential, right, the reference point is at infinity. At infinity, the potential energy is said to be zero. Therefore, at infinity, at a distance of infinity. Now, let us consider this is the positive charge. Now, here a unit positive charge. Here is the unit positive charge. Right. To define the potential at this point, take a unit positive charge, move from infinity distance to this point. Already there is a positive charge. Now this is the unit positive charge, which is also positive charge. Here between these two, there is a repulsive force, right? Because of the repulsive force, it will try to move away. While defining the potential, you want to move against to the field. Therefore, the work done by a unit positive charge in moving from infinity point to this point, that work done is called electric potential at that particular point. Now, there is a charge. There is a point P. What is the potential at this point? Right? What is our reference point? Infinity point is the reference point. Take a unit positive charge, move from infinity point to this point. There is a work done. That work done is called electric potential. Therefore, the electric potential is defined as WV is equals to W by Q. Right? Here W by Q naught, this is also what to say, Q naught. Now what here, this is called source charge. Now this is called Q naught is the test charge. Now where Q naught is the test charge, Q naught is the test charge. If the test charge is unit positive charge plus 1 coulomb, V is equals to W by Q naught is equals to 1, W is equals to V. Now, there is a charge. Around the charge, there is an electric field. In that electric field, at a particular point P, what is the potential? To define the potential at that point, take a unit positive charge, move from infinity distance to this point. Without doing work, it will not move from infinity distance to this point. An external agent will do work. The work done by the external agent to move unit positive charge from infinity distance to this point is called electric potential. Therefore, there is a charge, there is an electric field. At a particular point, you want to define the potential. Take a unit positive charge, move from infinity to that point, there is a work done. That work done is called electric potential. What is the electric potential formula generally? Right, V is equals to W by Q. Right, Q is the test charge. Now, what is the potential difference? Now, this is called charge. Now, this is called, what to say, electric field. Let us consider there is a point A and there is a point B. At the point A, what is the potential? VA. At the point B, what is the potential? VB. Now, the potential difference between these two points. In the previous case, we have defined the potential. In this case, we are defining the potential difference. To define the potential difference between these two points, take a unit positive charge, right? Move from this point to this point. Again, there is a work done. That work done is called potential difference between those two points. Whenever we are moving from A point to B point, A point is the initial point, B point is the final point, right? What is the initial potential? VA. What is the final potential? VB. That is, final potential minus initial potential is equals to, what to say, change in potential is equals to, difference in potential is equals to, work done by the charge. Now, we can define electric potential as well as electric potential difference. Right? Electric potential, the work done by the unit positive charge in moving from infinity to a point in the electric field is called electric potential. Now, electric potential difference, the two points are within the electric field, A point and B point, within the electric field. But while defining the potential, the point is inside the electric field. Now, next point is at infinity. We are moving the charge from infinity to that point. Now, whereas in the electric potential difference, now there is a charge, there are two points, A and B. These two are within the field. Take a unit positive charge, move from infinity distance to this point. There is a work done. That work done is called potential difference. Therefore, what is the potential difference? The work done by the unit positive charge in moving between any two points in the electric field is called potential difference. I am moving from A to B. Initial point A, final point B. That initial potential VA, final potential VB. The potential difference VB minus VA is equals to DV is equals to W by Q. Now here, general formula, V is equals to W by Q. Right. In another words, in moving between any two points, there is a potential energy difference. That potential energy difference per unit charge is also known as the electric potential difference. Now here V is equals to W by Q. Now that is W is the work done. Work done unit is joule, right? Charge unit is coulomb. Therefore, V is equals to, that is what to say, joules per coulomb. Therefore, joules per coulomb is known as volt. Joule per coulomb is known as volt. Therefore, what is the unit of potential difference? The unit of potential difference is called volt. Therefore, what is the general formula? V is equals to W by Q. It is the definition. Now, what is the unit? V is equals to W by Q. W is the work done, joule. Q is the charge, that is coulomb. Joules per coulomb. Joules per coulomb is known as volt. How to define volt? If 1 joule of work is done in moving between any two points by moving 1 coulomb, then the potential is said to be 1 volt.